Hello everyone, DonellHD here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up the Wiimote for PS2 light gun games with PCSX2 on LaunchBox. The requirements for this tutorial are one Mayflash Dolphin Bar and one Wiimote. Now I'm not going to go through the whole process of telling you how to install the Wii Bar because it's pretty self-explanatory and it's plug and play. But once you have plugged it in, press the sync button on the Dolphin Bar and press the sync button on the Wiimote. Both items will blink, but once the Wiimote turns to a solid color, you're good to go. The bar will blink for a little bit longer and then eventually turn solid as well. Now we can continue with the rest of the tutorial. As per usual, I have my arcade folder here, and inside that folder, I have my LaunchBox folder, my emulators folder, and the ROMs folder where we're going to be keeping our ROMs. I left the Dropbox link for everything you're going to need to get set up right away. All you have to do is click here on download. Okay, I've downloaded the PCSX2 light gun file and I've pasted it here on my desktop. What I'm going to do now is extract the contents of it into the emulators folder. Alright, now we're going to run the emulator for the first time. So I'm going to go to the emulators folder, the PCSX2 folder, and the PCSX2 EXE here. Now that the emulator has opened, I'm going to go to Settings, Controllers. In the menu here to the left, configure controller 1 and 2 like you want, because some light gun games require you to press the X button on the controller to begin. Select USB port 1, GunCon 2. Everything here is pre-configured for the Wiimote and mouse except for the calibration shot, which is sometimes required to pass the setup screen in some light gun games. So I'm going to set the calibration shot to a key I have chosen. You can use your own. Now I'm going to go up here and select settings. Here in the crosshair image path, I left the crosshair image in the emulator folder if you require it, or you can use your own. It does have to be a PNG file though. So I'm going to go here in my emulators folder and we're going to select the crosshair folder, and the crosshair is here. Now I'm going to click close. Now I'm going to go to settings, graphics. Here in the graphics section under renderer, we're going to drop this down arrow here, and if using a graphics card, select Vulkan. If not, select OpenGL. And under adapter, select your graphics card. Adjust your display and rendering settings as needed for your PC. And I'm going to go ahead and click close. Now I'm going to close the emulator all the way. And it's time to set it up in LaunchBox. Okay, now that we're here in LaunchBox, I'm going to go up here to the top left hand corner here. Going to go to Tools, Manage, Emulators. As you can see, I have a few emulators up here already. My original DuckStation, my DuckStation Light Gun, my PCSX2 original, and now I'm going to click add to add a PCSX2 for light gun. So I'm going to click add. The emulator name, we're going to name it PCSX2. After we name that, click here into this box to let it auto-populate, and then go back up here and then add light gun to the end of this name here. Now we're going to set the path. Once again, it's in my arcade, emulators, PCSX2 folder, and the PCSX2 EXE here. Now go up here to associated platforms, and I'm going to uncheck this box here. Now I'm going to click OK, and close. Now go ahead and install your games. Okay, I didn't go through the process of showing you how to import the games this time because I've done that many times before in my previous tutorials. So after importing your ISOs in the LaunchBox, activate your Wiimote or mouse and direct it to the center on the calibration screen. Then press the calibration shot button I mentioned earlier in the tutorial. Press A or B to exit. I had no issues running Time Crisis 2. Here is Ninja Assault working fine. Crisis Zone. And finally, Vampire Hunters. I'd like to thank everyone for watching. If this video helped you out in any way, please consider dropping a like and subscribing to the channel. I have many more video tutorials as well. If you wish to see them, just click on the links on the screen. As always, I'm DonellHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.